and they freed us that morning. And in hindsight, they intentionally, the Khmer Rouge soldiers, prison guards, they intentionally wanted to preserve us kids. I have no question that that's what they did, because they separated my three older brothers to preserve them from the death, from killing the whole population. They knew they because the whole population of the prison was killed that night. And so they separated my three older brothers because they didn't want them to be part of the population set out to be killed. And then when they came in that night, the second time I think they thought I had been asleep. And when they saw that I was still awake, was not asleep, they left right away. And that was what was so strange. And that was when I asked my mom. But what is so amazing, and to this day it's still incomprehensible to me. One, their strand of compassion for us amidst the darkness and the complete evil of the situation. And two, what is so amazing is how did the prisoners leave that cabin without waking me and my youngest brother? How did my mom untangled herself out of our embrace without waking us? They must have tiptoed to their death, which is really incredible. I mean, it's incredible to think that the prisoners tiptoed to their death, seeing us, because they didn't want to wake us. They know their fate. They must have been extremely fearful and full of emotions, but they restrained themselves to the point of not waking us up, because if we had been awakened as they were being taken to their death, we would have been taken along as well. I can't imagine that all of a sudden they would stop the executions of the tens or of the hundreds of the prisoners just so that they could wait for another night so we could go to sleep again. So to me, that's just incredible.